This is a Headgum original.
In 1977, NASA sent two solid gold records into space so that aliens might find them and understand life on Earth.
I send greetings on behalf of the people of our planet
and friendly wishes to all who may encounter this Voyager.
Now, we're making new records with our friends.
Bonjour tout le monde.
Konnichiwa.
Hola y saludos a todos.
Assalamu alaikum.
We step out of our solar system into the universe seeking only peace and friendship. We know full well that our planet and all its inhabitants are but a small part of this immense universe that surrounds us.
Hello from the children of planet Earth.
This afternoon.
You're being absolutely freaking awesome.
Just so everyone knows, Shelby and I have been kind of hanging out together this afternoon before the record, which we don't always get to do.
So you're going to notice a little bit of a little energy in the air.
If I would describe Shelby's energy today as this. Come to the dark side. We have cookies. Shelby's giving trash panda. Blah, blurg. Shelby's giving blurg this afternoon. Shelby. Shelby's giving, my day's been a dumpster fire, blurg.
Caleb's giving, I woke up today and just had to do all the things.
I had to feel all the feels.
Today's been such a frustrating day because I woke up and I was like, I wasn't going to do anything. And then I was like, you know what? I'm going to do all the things.
I'm just going to check things up. I'll do something, write it on my checklist just so I can cross it off.
Wait, you're being so random.
I'm sorry, adulting is not what I signed up for. Don't talk to me until I've had 3 glasses of wine.
Daddy needs his daddy juice.
Ew, that's a different thing. Daddy? Entering daddy into it?
When it says mommy juice, I was just not going to call you mommy.
You can call me mommy for the bit. Just for the bit, though.
Mommy needs her mommy juice.
Oh my God, that's so funny. I'm dead, girl.
I'm dead.
You're literally like funny.
No,
you're like funny.
No, I'm gagged.
No, literally, you're like funny, though.
No,
you're literally funny.
No, you're
No.
What?
You're literally like, you crack
me
up.
That's so crazy. People used to say I should be on Mad TV.
You're one of the funniest bitches I've ever encountered.
Yeah, people used to be like, wait, you should be on Mad TV.
Literally.
Literally,
you're literally. So funny. Because like when you're around.
People are laughing.
I'm like laughing, crying, laughing. Because you're like a funny ass bitch. And I fucking mean that to my core. You should be on fucking TV, girl.
For those on YouTube, Kayla bought me this coffee.
Yeah. Not to brag, but I have it like that.
Not to brag, but he's got it like that.
Not to brag, but things are going well. I can buy my friend's coffee. Actually, coffee is getting expensive. You do need to Venmo me for that. I'm going to be requesting PayPal. Anyway, what's up with you?
Oh, nothing.
Boop.
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 Boop. Stop.
No.
Are you flirting with me today?
A little.
Oh.
What am I not?
What do you think we would do sexually? Why?
I.
Why do I always do that?
Don't know.
I think
and then
it's
I was
funny
like, I don't know.
Me.
It depends on the location.
Location's the first place you went.
Yeah. I wanted to set the scene.
Yeah. Well, I don't really want to talk about how I'm doing. Don't ask.
How are you doing?
I'm fine.
All right, our guest today.
You can't even. They're not here yet.
We could record ads or something.
Yeah, we could just chill downtime. I'm dating, as you know.
Right. Are you trying to celebrate what I think you're trying to celebrate?
What am I trying to celebrate?
Something about dating and phones and application.
Oh my God. No, I literally was not thinking of that, but I did finally, listeners. I got approved for Raya. I got approved for Raya, and guess
this
what?
This is Caleb's biggest career moment of the month, and Jurassic Park came out this month.
I got approved for Raya, which famously has a fatphobic bias, and I knew it would be bad, but I had to know what it would be like to be on there, and guess what? It's bad. It's not enjoyable. I don't want them to kick me off, though. Please don't kick me off, you guys. I'm gonna learn to love it.
it's so just far, an it's acquired bad. Taste.
It's just like photographers and people who work at agencies being like, hey.
Well, sometimes you want headshots.
Looking for literally. It's like, and it's like connect with nearby mutuals. And then it'll be like, this person knows this person that you know because of your phone contacts. He works in touring at an agency.
I don't like when anything tells me this is from your contacts. Yeah. I say leave it alone.
And then the bios are always like, looking for drinks and an adventure. And then like a clinking glass emoji. Oh, God, please kill me.
TikTok is always like, I'm showing you this because they're in your phone. I'm like, I have people in my phone that I care not to see.
I have to say, I don't feel comfortable making many jokes about outlawing gayness anymore because it is getting pretty weird with the public homophobia.
Yeah.
And I do have, by the way, I'll just tell our listeners, I have a Comedy Central stand-up set coming out where I do a joke about gayness, and I'm not sure how I feel about it, but we're going to see. I recorded it before everything got as weird as it is now, but homophobia having a major comeback moment.
Thank God.
I know, a little bit.
I was getting too comfortable with it.
It was hotter when being gay was dangerous.
And it's going to get hot again. Yeah.
if conservatives have anything to say about it.
If the U-Haul of it all from the other day means anything,
being gay's about to get real hot again.
Make gay hot again.
It is getting scary. But it is going to make it sexier.
Yeah.
Sex when you're not supposed to be doing it.
That's the good stuff.
Yeah, if you could get in trouble for it. Like, it's like, oh, someone wants to beat me up if they found out I did this. Hot, you know?
Till the time comes.
Till
payment day.
Well, if you can't fight, you better stop sucking dick. It's getting dark out here. I can fight, so I'll be sucking guys off if I want to, and vice versa. But I'll fight as well.
What's going on with it, though?
Homophobia?
Yeah.
It's having a major comeback, and it's timing
up. I guess that is, like,
with a looming recession.
Fads are so cyclical.
Fads are cyclical. It's timing up with a recession, so people are going to need a scapegoat group soon. It's probably going to be queer people.
Which is crazy.
Yeah, the recession, or...
For recession to be at the fault of queer people.
Yeah. Well,
I can't imagine the mental gymnastics to get that parallel.
Well, when things start going bad politically and economically, it's always the same big groups. It's like
the Jews.
Jews, queer people,
fuck.
Of course,
fuck.
Always
fuck,
black
fuck,
people.
Fuck.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Yeah, you're it's not things are also things are not looking good for you.
Okay.
I can at least pretend to be Christian. No, we're going to be fine. Right? Fuck. Right?
This is like when people are like, I might have to move to Canada.
Oh, I'm not moving anywhere.
What's up?
I'll stay. I'll fight for this country.
I mean, I'm not
going
to move to Canada.
Because I'm proud to be an American. Well, at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died who gave that right.
Can I tell you what I always think the beginning is?
Yes, I wish you would.
I might have said this before.
Say it now.
But I'm proud to be an American. I always think it's where at least I can die free.
And that technically is true.
I can die for free.
You can die for free in the United States. All you have to do is go outside.
But my dependents are fucked.
Your dependents?
Yeah.
Do you have kids?
Like three.
You would have told me.
No, you've met them.
You can die in America for free. Actually, not even true. A lot of times it costs. Yeah,
there's a fee, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Funeral home.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I'm learning a lot about the fees of death, and I got to tell you.
Death certificates?
No bueno. Yeah.
Death certificates you have
and
to buy?
Those come in.
And they can't be made. You can't make copies of them. You have to ask them for the copies and pay? Death certificates are a scam. Piece of paper says he died. We know he died, bitch. I'm looking at the body.
There's stuff about when people die that I'm learning now. I say, what are we doing glue with about this? Yeah. Why are we doing this? I say, Mr. President, make a change.
Oh, no. You're addressing Mr. President on this one?
Wait. Free cloth for the girlies.
Joe Biden. You have been killing it, bitch.
No,
free cloth for Joe Biden.
Free cloth for the girlies. When Pink said, Dear Mr. President.
Dear Mr. President, were you a lonely boy? That song actually.
Let's pretend.
We're just two people in.
You're not
better than me. I'd like to ask you some questions.
If you
can speak honestly. What do you see when you look in the mirror?
Are you proud?
That song bangs, dude.
She went off. I'm sorry, Pink.
Pink on Dear Mr. President. People want what she has, dude.
Pink said, I saw what happened to the chicks. I don't care.
I don't care. I'll be taking George W. Bush to task.
My fan base will be fine with it.
What kind of father might hate his own daughter if she were gay? Yeah.
And what kind of father
might take his own daughter's rights away? God damn.
Trying to remember
some. I wish I could think of more of it. I wish I could sing the whole song for you right now.
I think I probably could.
Do you guys know what we're talking about, listeners? Little freaks.
Anya, do you know what we're talking about?
You guys don't know Dear Mr. President? I'm playing it. I'm not even going to wait for them to play it.
I'm so mad at Anya right now.
What kind of father may hate his own daughter?
This is a song, as the listeners might know, freakies, that Pink wrote to George Bush. No, when he was in presidency. Da 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 da.
Dear Mr. President, come get a lonely boy. Lonely boy.
Lonely boy. Yes, gospel.
Ooh, come on now.
How can you say no child is left behind? We're not dumb and we're not blind. We're sitting in your cells while you pave the road to hell. What kind of father takes his own daughter's rights away? And what kind of father might hate his own daughter if she were gay?
Come on.
I can only imagine what the first lady has to say.
You've come a long way.
Go off, go the fuck off on this.
From whiskey and cocaine. How do you sleep while the rest of us cry?
My lighter would be in the fucking air right now if we were live.
How do you dream? Come on, no chance to say goodbye.
Yeah.
Take it down.
Come on.
Can you even look me in the eye?
Let me tell
you about
hard work.
Come on.
Come on.
With a baby on the way.
Let me tell you about hard work.
In the positive way.
Let me tell you how it works. Building a bed out of a cardboard box.
Let me tell you how it works. She roasted his ass on a platter. George W. Bush found dead, hypothetically. George W. Anya. Anya entering her political era. Anya, anything you want to say to the listeners? Casey, anything you want to say to the listeners?
No, not today.
I think our fans should be more rabid. I think our fans should be going harder. Little freaks, go harder on the internet. I think so. I think so.
And more I love tags. You and I love you guys.
I want more tags.
And I love you guys.
I want more people to tag us and say, I loved this moment.
I want you to treat your fandom like an occupation.
Yeah. Standing us should be a job.
And you should be trying to get ahead.
Yeah. You should be looking for a promotion, honey. Standing us should be work. Stand this pod like your bills depend on it. The rent's due. Pay up.
Pay up. Pay up.
What do you think is your biggest weakness?
I've told you this before. It's my personality.
I guess I have asked you that before.
Yeah.
Well, what do you think is number two?
Unfortunately, all that's left, aesthetic.
Aesthetic?
Yeah.
You think your aesthetic is a weakness? I think you have a powerful aesthetic. I look at you and I say, there's someone who is undeniably gay.
Does not care what she looks like.
Undeniably gay. Could at any moment go on a hike. I think you have...
I'm in clogs.
Honey, the clogs even still are giving... it's giving person who could go on a hike.
You couldn't hike in these.
You don't have to hike in those because you know what those clogs tell me? She's got boots in the truck.
In the car.
She's got boots. She's got boots and granola in the truck.
Granola.
She got boots and granola in the truck.
This little lady's got boots and granola.
She got granola in the truck. And carabiners.
I do have kind of whatever you need in my car.
That's I've driven
kind
your of car.
My energy is... Sonia got signs made.
Sonia.
Oh my Sonia. God.
It's Sonia.
It's giving Sonia.
We don't have to wrap up.
Okay.
Our guest is here.
Fuck. I mean, yay.
But also, fuck. Yeah. Because we were really just, I feel hitting our groove. Yeah. Talking about you, the way you look was really going to take off.
We were going to really get into what my car is like.
Yeah. Fuck. But well, our guest today, we absolutely love him. He's killing it on TikTok.
We love him very much. Very funny comedian based in LA.
Please put your fins, paws, flippers, and human hands, if you got them, together for our dear friend, EJ Marcus. I don't think we've ever put this in. We can put this in. This will be cute. You want to do it together? Okay.
Okay, say we'll just chat. Listen. Okay.
We'll just chat with you.
And that'll go for however long.
Sometimes it goes for like 40 minutes.
And sometimes 15.
Sometimes less. Okay. So we'll chat with you. And then at some point, we'll get into your items. You can bring them up in whatever order you want. Doesn't matter. Okay. Got them right there.
And then we'll take a break.
We'll take a break for ads.
Okay. And then, Anya, you don't know this yet, but we're going to do an artifact. We're going to do Morse code ships.
Cute.
So we'll play a little sound for you. And then we'll just like talk about it.
And then we'll do delete it, which is where you delete something from the records.
Yeah.
And you need to be stressed about or remember none of this because we'll be in charge of it. So you just
yeah,
we're
fun. Just telling you so that nothing comes as a surprise later, but we will prompt.
Yeah.
You.
Okay.
And if it ever seems like Shelby has an attitude problem, trust me, I get it. She doesn't mean to be that way.
It's okay. The way I was raised.
Yeah, no, I can see that. Yeah.
She just comes off that way.
Okay.
She's actually really cool.
Okay.
Once you get to know her.
Yeah.
Nice.
It takes a while.
Yeah. Okay, but what we were talking about before.
I've been told.
Anya. You actually, to me, do seem gay, but that's just because you have a tattoo.
Yeah.
You actually do seem gay to me. But I'll tell you why I would have clocked you as straight is because you're wearing baby doll socks. And that's a straight girl thing to do.
Gabby wears those.
Yeah.
Our straightest friend.
You're wearing baby doll socks.
I didn't know that was a straight thing to do.
Don't you think?
Yeah, definitely. It's the ruffles. It's the, like, okay. Joy. Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess it's like...
You have a radical hetero joy.
Straight
girls are always kind of trying to be like toddlers.
Yeah. Because men like that and women are kind of like, we don't need that.
Ding, ding, ding.
Yeah. Most straight men at their core are a little bit of pedophiles.
Yeah, for sure.
Sorry, they really have kind of feel like it's weird.
I feel like we're allowed to talk about
like
this. Little
baby
girls.
The whole concept of daddy.
Yeah. But I've been called daddy. The girls who can barely string sentences together. They're like really gross.
Pigtails.
I always try to dumb myself down to like third grade level.
Do you?
I talk to men.
Huh? Does it work?
I didn't know you were working at that.
Wow. Shelby.
I wouldn't have caught you as straight.
Guys,
though.
I'm kidding. Anya and I have a really good friendship.
That's true.
Yeah. Beautiful. You guys hang out a lot without me, which I find interesting.
Oh.
We are neighbors.
We are neighbors, which is nice.
Cool. We always talk about meeting up, which is cool too.
But we've never done it.
Correct.
Met up?
Correct.
Aww.
We've never met.
You never met.
That was like really awkward, right?
Yeah, that was super awkward. Yeah. Honestly, I feel really weird.
Yeah, I'm not comfortable here. EJ, no. We have each other.
Yeah, thank God.
Would it help if I left?
Left?
The podcast?
Or left.
Oh, forever.
Me and EJ do an episode?
Yeah.
Actually, do you mind? Stay. Whoa, Nelly.
Hey, you can't even get up.
EJ, so you started this episode by walking into the studio and immediately insulting our producer.
Yeah.
Tell the listeners a little bit about that point of view.
I mean, honestly, like, I didn't think it was going to come out of me, but I felt like I couldn't hold it in anymore.
Yeah.
Just kind of one of those things that bubbled up. But, I mean, like, yeah, I like to enter spaces, like, pretty aggressive. Like,
dominant.
I feel like that's how people describe me. They're, like, mean, scary, like, tall, intimidating. Yeah.
I'm so glad that you brought this up because we were nervous because I think people online really think, like, you're so nice.
You're like a sweet little girl. Like,
there's a warm energy. And we were like, well, that's not...
Mm-hmm.
You're one of the most toxic people I've ever encountered. Yeah.
No, it's a huge problem. Yeah, because people are like, oh, hey, sweetie pie, pinch my cheeks. I'm like, I kick him in the shins, right? Yeah, it's like.
I'll never forget the first time I met you because I only knew you from online. And I thought, that's a sweet person. That's a warm person. And you, and I'll never forget this.
Yeah.
It's like seared in my brain. It was at Cheesecake Factory. You walked in and you threw your coat at the hostess.
Mm-hmm.
And you looked at me and you said, faggot.
Yeah.
And I, I was taken aback by that.
Yeah.
And then you did. You called me fat. Mm. And I thought that was really.
Do you remember when you broke my nose?
Yeah.
Oh
yeah.
My god.
That was so fun.
You
still
asked
haven't
for it.
Fixed it.
You asked for it, I will say.
Yeah, you were like, do it. What are you going to do? Do it. And I was like,
what are you
going
to do?
Okay.
Do it.
The balls in the wall. Pussy, you know, calling all kinds of names. Calling all kinds of names.
Pussy, pussy.
Yeah. Pussy, pussy.
Yeah.
Coward. Pussy, pussy, pussy.
Coward, pussy, pussy.
Yeah.
And then EJ, yeah. Thwacked you.
Yeah. I mean, people cheered. I don't know if you remember that part, though.
No, I do. I will say, a little bit of blur because the concussion, but I do remember that energy at least.
Mm.
But so good to have you on.
Oh my gosh. You guys, I'm so happy to be here. I've been amazing.
Do you love LA?
I'm obsessed.
what's your favorite power lunch spot?
Oh my gosh. Honestly, I'm freezing. Vons. I mean,
Vons!
what are your dietary restrictions?
I've thank closed
you
every
for
deal
asking.
At Vons.
Yeah, thank you.
Every deal I've done, I've closed at Vons.
Every day, yeah.
I say, meet me at the Starbucks in Vons.
Yeah, meet me at the Starbucks in Vons.
They have tables, so we just stand there.
Yeah, just stand, lean against the counter. They love that. They like you to linger there.
I like
yeah.
the Starbucks at Target.
Oh, yeah.
That's
really good energy.
Extremely corporate. I'm sorry, I have to disagree with you both. That's extremely corporate.
Mm. More than the Vons?
Vons is family, mom and pop.
Mm-hmm.
Vons is mom and pop.
Yeah.
Mom and pop.
The Frappuccinos
Vons
are like,
mom and pop.
They churn them.
I have a question
they
for
churn
everyone.
The the milk for the Frappuccinos.
They churn the milk for the Frappuccinos, of course, we all know. Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a question for the room.
If it's appropriate, I will allow you to ask it.
It's extremely Vons related. Mm. John's. If it's same font.
Different.
Also grocery store. Is it same owners?
Vons is for girls and John's is for boys, I believe.
Mm-hmm. That's what I also heard.
And then anyone who doesn't fall into one of those categories.
But it's the same owners.
Does, unfortunately, have to go to Sprouts.
I understand it's the same.
Does. Or you can go to Trader. If you're non-binary, you can go to Trader Joe's, but.
Yeah.
You then you have to deal with their whole shtick, yeah.
You shouldn't.
You shouldn't.
You shouldn't, yeah. Anyway.
Yeah.
All right.
Does that answer your
question?
Just
thought I'd
ask. Does that help?
Is that good?
This is the Headgum podcast.
This is a Headgum original. EJ, what would you say is your biggest enemy in the world? Who do you hate the most?
Who do I hate the most?
Not in this room.
Oh, okay, well, great.
Leave Anya out of it. She's
I'm trying to leave
She's
Anya
not
out of
enough.
It. I don't really know how I can.
She's
but
on the ropes.
My biggest enemy in the world. Oh, my goodness. Oh, gosh. Honestly, like, no. It's ridiculous. My biggest enemy in the world is probably I just got scared. I honestly, a neighbor. I have a neighbor.
Oh, okay. But you don't want to talk about it. You're scared to talk about it.
I'm a little
in
scared
public.
To talk about it. But I'll
this
call
gets a
them
lot of...
I'll call them my coworker.
Yeah.
Okay, so they're my coworker and they never say hi to me.
Faggot.
Yeah.
They are a faggot.
They never say hi to me, and I feel like I mean, I know we talked about this, that, like, I can, like, people, like, think I'm nice or whatever, but I'm actually mean. But to them, I swear I'm nice. I'm
you,
a disc.
All jokes aside, hey. You are a very warm
very
person.
Warm
I would say
nice.
Hello to you.
Okay, thank you.
If I didn't
I would
you.
Too.
Yeah.
Would you?
I think I have.
Okay.
Why do you think they won't say hi to you?
I think we knew each other and I was and I did.
This is my thing. I think that I don't know if it's, like, a syndrome of, like, I think that – like, I usually get said hi to because I would call myself someone with a big, warm smile. I don't know if that's crazy, but, like,
it's
you,
true.
You identify
true.
As someone with a big, warm smile.
I identify as someone with a big, warm smile, a sparkle in my eye.
Yeah.
And
a little twinkle.
A twinkle in your eye.
A twinkle in my eye,
A pep in your step.
And
And,
they just don't say hi to me. And I really, like, it's gotten to the point where I'm, like, I'm staring. I'm, like, hey. Like, because we walk by, like, the way that the shop is set up. Is
right,
we
coworker.
Walk. It's coworker.
I was like, wait a minute.
I was on the same
got
page.
It.
I understand.
Got it.
Shelby's on. The way the shop is set up, we're walking by each other pretty constantly. Not constantly. Every once a day.
Do you think there's a sexual component?
Jealousy?
Sexual jealousy. Yeah. Sexual jealousy.
Jealousy, yeah. Maybe. I think that I don't know what it is, but I just feel like I wish that I want to connect. It's making it, I'm obsessing because it's something I can't have.
EJ, I've seen online that you are a fellow fan of something that we're very fond of on this podcast. So I'm wondering if we get a free clout for the girlies. Supergoop.
Supergoop.
Supergoop. We fuck with Supergoop.
Okay.
This is a super goop pod.
Super goop glow screen.
Okay, thank goodness.
We're in it with them. Yeah. We love it.
Yeah.
Send us. We're going to let this be about for the girlies. Super goop, if you're listening, send some.
Send it more.
Send some.
Please. All three of us.
To all three of us. We'll share with EJ.
Yeah.
Send some.
Yeah.
Not with us.
No. Well, because you guys have both been pretty weird today.
We lost your super goop privilege.
You guys came out as straight to us during Pride.
If you guys aren't using super goop, I gotta tell you.
It really is something special. It really is something special. And EJ, I know what you're thinking. Surely Shelby won't be touching the microphone the whole time.
Well, I will.
Shelby has a podcasting style where she does every episode like this. She's back and forth like this.
Like
she's cradling the mic.
If you guys heard that in the mic, unless they edit it out, which they can and they should. That was residual from my COVID. I had COVID.
Shelby has
weeks
COVID
ago.
Presently.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
A couple weeks ago, I had COVID, and sometimes when I laugh, it's you can still hear her in there.
She's in there.
She's in there.
Stop laughing.
Wait. I have a question.
Yeah.
Are you familiar with the song "Dear Mr. President" by Pink?
Absolutely.
Dear Mr. You President. Are.
Ooh.
Were you a lonely boy? We played some of it in our intro. We're obsessed.
Oh my god, it's amazing. Did you just discover it?
No.
Or? No.
Anya had never heard it. Casey, we'll more you time had with it.
I might have.
That's
Casey.
Literally. You would have known. Casey, if you had heard it before, you would have known.
That's because they're straight. I literally feel like, I mean, Pink is straight. I know that.
But.
I want to say that I know that.
But. In many ways, she's not.
Look at her. Yeah, right? Like.
Actually, do
is
you want to know?
She's still dating that motocross guy?
Married.
I think they're married and
with
have
children.
Yeah.
I thought for a really long time they like refused to get married but had kids. Like they were like,
it was like a political we won't until the gays can or something like that. Yeah.
Oh, well, the gays can now, unfortunately.
Yeah, I think they can.
Or Burgerfell. Yeah, for now.
Hold on to that one.
Shelby and I, we used to live next door to Pink's bass guitarist.
Are you serious?
And she was
Los Angeles.
Oh my god, this town.
She was a friend.
A friend. A good friend.
Yeah.
We had her over a number of times.
She lent my girlfriend a book and it took a very long time to return it.
Yeah. So
I mean that's
So Shelby ruined the relationship.
Sure.
Shelby and Lindsay did a little joint project on ruining
Lindsay
the relationship.
Did. And Lindsay, if you're listening, first of all, hi.
Get that book back.
First of all, hey. Hey.
Throwing dirt on your name, girl.
miss you. But you should have returned the book a little quicker.
Yeah. Right.
Couldn't have hurt.
Because that could have been huge. I mean, the guitarist, bass guitarist.
God,
bass
guitarist.
Could be sitting in this chair right now.
We should ask her to start playing bass in the room while we podcast.
We should insult her deeply. Yeah. We should ask her to do something far below her skill level.
Yeah, come on.
Would you stand in the corner while we do our podcast? Which, by the way, is completely off the rails. And almost every episode forgets the premise at some point. Would you stand in the corner and play bass guitar as a world-class guitarist?
Oh, you don't think that would be fun for her?
Shelby did a bit on the pod last week that was so aggressive that it actually
wasn't that aggressive, but I did watch it on the YouTube video, and the problem is that I was on a delay. So it was a mid-year sentence, but when I said it was before we went.
It was so crazy. I had to stop the recording and be like, just so you know, that was incredibly violent.
Mm.
Like, it was so... I thought about it, like, at least once an hour since.
It's replaying in your mind.
He was talking about a band that had a lot of horns in it, and he was really getting kind of revved up. And
the lead singer is so hot.
And Carly said, so there's a lot of horns, and I said, like, from the way he's talking about it.
Shelby did, like, a Rodney Dangerfield, which she does, I would say, twice an episode average.
But which is when I said it was... Right after Carly spoke, before you it spoke, but when it came through on the recording, it is 8 seconds into him responding.
I'm in like the middle of the sentence. And Shelby goes, yeah, he's talking about it.
Because he's literally just
so you're
like,
wasted,
he's
yeah.
like, no, there are, there's a lot. He's so excited. He's like, has so much love in his heart for this band. He's like, no, yeah, there's a lot of horns. And I go, from the way he's talking about it, it sounds like there's some horns.
Do you have a go-to voice, EJ?
Oh, gosh. I mean...
Shelby's just, eat this right here. Doing one of these.
Yeah, it's gonna go ahead and be this guy.
That's Shelby.
Yeah. He stirs go-to. Up trouble. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, he's a problem.
No, he's a huge problem.
Yeah, I'd have him arrested if I could.
Yeah, me too.
And the secret to that character is just don't ask where he was on January 6th.
Right.
Because I'll tell you the answer.
At home with his
the
kids.
The Capitol. He was at the Capitol with Nancy Pelosi's...
At home with his kids.
He was behind Nancy Pelosi's desk.
At home with his kids.
He was taking illegal pictures. He's taking illegal pictures behind Nancy Pelosi's desk.
Right. I mean, he's saying he was at home with his kids.
Well, yeah, he doesn't want to be tried.
Yeah.
They're all getting tried right now.
Where's the proof?
Right.
Anyway.
Nothing even happened that day.
Nothing happened.
This is such a bad podcast, EJ. I'm sorry we brought you into it.
No, I'm like so happy to be here.
Shelby just defended the insurrection on the pod.
Somebody
it's like
has
completely
to.
Embarrassing. EJ, you can't when she gets like this.
When she's blidge.
Okay, well, we have to go to a break soon, but before we do, will you just tell us how you been lately? Give us a little how you been lately.
How have I been lately? Oh gosh, I got a haircut yesterday.
You look slick.
Okay.
I will say, you okay, look sharp. You look you. Sharp, and I mean it yes, from my heart.
Yes, yes. Yeah, I mean, I don't know if you've seen the back.
Yeah, it's literally yeah. sharp. Yeah.
Clean.
You look
clean,
good.
Clean.
And I will say, this was the first haircut I've ever gotten. I always go to a barbershop. I love a barbershop. Honestly, a lot of people are going to feel different about that. I love a barbershop. This was the first time that they have, sort of without asking, begun to shave my face.
Oh, they just went in on it?
They just went in on it.
Yeah, took the guard off?
Yeah.
Did a little shave up for you?
Yeah.
That's cute.
Which honestly felt awesome, but it was...
I was going to say, did you like it or hate it?
Well, it was just, like, so shocking. I guess they gave me, like, before that, they were giving me sort of the lighter treatment, if you know what I mean.
Were you growing more facial hair now than you used to?
Like, literally, no.
Oh, so they just weren't going in there. Like, here we go.
I think it was just, like, they were like, this is just a guy who needs his face shaved.
Who needs his face shaved.
And I was like, sure.
You said absolutely.
I felt,
every hair.
That's happened to me every haircut since I was, like, maybe 19.
Well, I think it's because they always think you're a boy.
Yeah. But you're a boy at the barbershop. Yeah, they should get your face.
So now they're doing my face. Yeah.
Yeah.
That felt like a milestone.
That's fucking cool.
Sorry to be... I don't know if that's too earnest for your listeners.
No, we love it.
Okay. No, are you kidding?
It also this just podcast literally also feels has good. The importance of being earnest. That's sort of
the importance
a
of being earnest
of
is a
the
huge
podcast.
Thing of the pod.
The importance being of being earnest.
Yeah.
So
it's hard
nothing's
sometimes.
Too earnest for the
there are There are two places that feel really good to me to have like a no guard, like when someone's shaving you. It's the face when they do that, when they're like doing your hair and then they just start doing your cheek.
Mm-hmm.
And then the back of the neck. But yeah. No, I don't have your neck. Does not feel so... Well, I don't know if you've ever had it. Oh, fuck.
You should try it sometime.
It feels so good, right? When they're, like, squaring it off. And
oh,
it's
my
like,
God. It feels so good. Because I'm like, you're doing
sometimes
something crazy
I
back
run.
There.
You're doing something absolutely crazy. Shelby's having, like, a gender dysphoria. Shelby's hot for body right now. Like, do I have to get a buzz cut?
Is that required?
Nothing would look worse on me.
Hey, I don't think that's true.
You guys are incorrect.
I've said this before. I've tried to get you to go short.
Yeah.
I showed my mom... a picture of the length hair that you want me to have, and this is my reaction. This is my impression of my mom seeing that.
Okay.
No.
Well, let me tell you something.
No.
Jillian, I'm a huge fan of yours. I love your work. You know that I have nothing but respect and love for you in my heart. You're wrong.
Yeah.
The length that I sent to you, we would look really good in, like a right here on Shelby with like a layered right here.
Oh, so cute.
Shelby would fuck that up.
Yeah. My mom said, no.
She's wrong because when you wear your hair over like that even long, it just looks so good. Guys, we have to go to a break for ads, and we have to call Shelby's mom. I got to talk to her about this. Let's do a break. Break. Microdosing magic mushrooms are here.
Yeah,
and
you can get it delivered
right to you.
If you're looking to take it to the next gear,
maybe a little bit of mooms can help you get there. It's known to increase energy, boost creativity, and self-understanding.
It's also being used to treat depression,
anxiety, and ADHD. We're living through an exciting time as we see many states move to accept psilocybin.
I'm excited to share Schedule 35 with everyone, a startup in the psychedelic space aimed at providing quality and easy-to-understand products for those interested in the
benefits
of microdosing.
Schedule 35 provides a reliable service with high-quality ingredients delivered discreetly to your doorstep.
To learn more about microdosing, check out Schedule 35. www.schedule35.co and be sure to use code GOLDEN to get 15% off your order. That's code GOLDEN to get 15% off your order today.
We cannot stress this enough. Go to www.schedule35.co and use code GOLDEN to get 15% off your order.
Code GOLDEN, 15% off your order.
Code GOLDEN, 15% off your order of shrooms. Many states are moving to an exciting new possibility with psilocybin.
Welcome back.
EJ.
Yeah.
Well, we brought you here for a reason.
Yeah.
So true. We wanted to know, we were talking to the ghost of Carl Sagan.
Oh, EJ, I'm so sorry. We were talking to the ghost of Carl Sagan, like Shelby said.
Yeah.
We were wondering if we made a new golden record.
Mm-hmm. He wanted to know, what would you put on it?
The ghost of Carl Sagan wanted to know.
Okay, awesome.
Okay.
Well, it's the first item on the record.
What would it be? Yeah. Well, here's my thing, you guys, is I know I was making a joke about this earlier, but I literally did write down what I would bring.
That's because
and I've got, oh, it's beautiful.
Oh my God.
And it's because I do feel like I've changed a lot since I originally kind of decided what I would bring.
Okay.
Huge. You're allowed that. You're allowed that.
Like, I feel like I don't know about you guys, but I'm changing constantly.
Yeah, you can change your list live if you wanted.
Oh, okay, cool. Do you really feel like you're changing a lot?
I honestly do.
We were going to say that you've changed.
As a person?
Yeah.
You've changed.
And you brought me here to talk about it.
You've changed, boy.
We brought you here for a reason. We were talking to the ghost of girls, and he was like, you just changed.
Yeah. He was like, and honestly, for the worst. Yeah.
I think
he doesn't know what he's talking about, though.
I think I stopped growing as a person in 2019.
Uh-oh. Okay, so that was pre-COVID.
2019, I reached who I'm going to be. And I'm still there.
Okay.
COVID did not change me.
Okay. Yeah. That's so cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's awesome. I hope that for everyone, too. I hope nobody changed a little tiny bit.
No growth? No, I'm kidding, I think. I don't know, though. What has changed about your list? Did it get more one way than the other?
Honestly, I was just thinking back to it, and I was looking at what I wrote, and I was like, did I write that?
Oh, my God, yeah.
I was like, I don't think I would send those things to space. Not all of them. But, like, specifically one I kept, and it's should I say it?
Yeah.
Yes. God, I'm so nervous. It's art with cats in it. It's cat art.
Okay. Okay. What do you mean? What do you mean, like old? Can I tell you two things came to my head?
Yeah.
Two things came to my head. Space cat. First one was space cat, like t-shirts of like cats in space.
Ooh.
Super random culture. Shelby's really into this kind of stuff.
Oh no.
Cats eating pizza in space.
No pizza.
Or like an old time painting with a cat in the background while a guy plays like a mandolin or something.
Okay.
Or neither.
Okay.
Those are the two things that came.
How do you feel about the latter?
I really like when a pet shows up in an old time painting.
Okay, awesome.
Me too. I like to remember that they were a part of it.
They were there.
Okay, that's cool. So yeah, I would say that mine's sort of similar to that. But okay. The kind of art that I'm drawn to.
Okay.
Like I like stuff. It's not random core. It's
thank God.
It's I would never.
That's my thing.
That's
somebody's extremely random sauce.
No, I can tell. What did you say when I came here? Oh, blue banana.
Shelby said random panda. Yeah. Awkward turtle.
Shelby said palm tree.
Wait, what did Shelby do to you when you got here?
Blue banana. Wink, wink. Yeah, you were like, what? I was like, what are you talking about?
Did you really? Shelby, were you being random with our guest?
No.
Okay, anyway, EJ. Art with cats.
It's like art with cats, but it's like, okay, I'll just give you an example of it exists in someone in this room's apartment. It's mine.
Okay, I was like,
have I had EJ over? I just got so nervous.
It's mine. But no, it's just like, it's a really well done sort of like, I don't know a lot about paints, but I would call it a paint. I would call it like.
Probably oil, maybe
probably
gauche.
Oil, something like that. And it's actually just like a portrait of an old Western gang. Mm. So these are like real people. And but instead of them being people, it's cats and like cowboy hats and bandanas.
I fuck with that.
Yeah. And they're all like labeled and they all have like the histories of the members of the gang. It was actually given to me by a dear friend for my birthday. So I actually just came on this podcast to talk about this piece of art because I think we should take the whole hour and sort of dissect it.
That's fine. You're kidding, but that's fine with us. What is the gang? Do you remember?
The Jesse James.
Oh, Missouri boy.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's a Missouri boy.
Well, and he's front center in the painting.
Named Jesse James?
I don't know, but thank you for asking.
And I think an NFL tight end.
Wait, do you guys know the song Jesse James by Cher?
Do you know?
No.
There's another song, Jesse James, by someone else, but it is not Cher.
This is just like Jesse James by Cher.
Now imagine a cat singing it.
Yep.
Okay. to Sharon and go, I forget that she's really good.
She's really good.
It's like she's such a name that it's like, I forget that she's good.
I know. I mean, I look at her Twitter pretty often.
She's damaging her legacy by being on Twitter.
Yeah.
Her behavior on Twitter is absolutely damaging her legacy. Did you guys see the one from today?
Yes.
No, what was the one
today? I'm going to read you. Her behavior on Twitter is absolutely stealing her spot in the Hall of Fame.
What's the punctuation? Is the capitalization?
What do you guys think about, while you pull that up, Dolly Parton requesting not to be added into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame yet, and then they did it anyway?
I didn't know that happened, but
she
I'm
was
upset
like,
for her.
She was like, I want other people to get in, so consider me another time. And then they were like, you're in, baby doll.
Well, she said she was like, I'm a country star, not a rock and roll.
No, she said... maybe she made another statement. I remember her initial statement was like, there are people who are nominated who should get it over me. And she was like, so consider me in the future, but not yet. I haven't earned it yet.
She tweeted these two things within an hour of each other. And I'm not even going to attempt to tell you about the punctuation.
Yeah.
Or the spelling. I'm not even going to try to tackle the punctuation or spelling.
Just tell it to us letter by letter.
Just took worst picks ever. Oh. Butt kids ever. I look with cool young kids. Look like a troll. Smugged eye makeup. Look like 3 miles of bad road. Came to see dear friend who's sick. An hour later. Okay, someone call emergency and take my phone away forever. I was texting and talking to friends, and my mind was invaded by a creature from another galaxy. He invaded my body too. That wasn't so bad. Sure, he's denying it now. Share. Share. Who? However, in my defense, my phone's on drugs. Whoa. Have you ever heard something so batshit in your life?
I actually don't think we can laugh about it. I think that's someone sick.
I know.
I mean, and to read it is like truly even crazier. I don't, listeners, if you can see this.
Right.
Listeners, go to the YouTube.
What do you think is worse, that or the NFTs Madonna's selling?
Madonna selling NFTs?
I'm not up to date, you
Madonna's
guys.
Madonna selling NFTs where she is, first of all, she's got a lot of work done. More than you can imagine.
Right.
And she's on a table, like an operating table, it seems, spreading her legs, and a tree's coming out of her pussy.
You did not have to say pussy.
What was I
going
to say?
You could have said vagina. You could have kept it medical.
Ew!
Pussy. Okay, there's a tree coming out of her pussy.
I think, you know why I had to say pussy?
Well, pussy does give life.
Well, I had to say pussy because of how vulgar the images are. You can't say, it's not medical. It's,
yeah.
It's
artistic. It's
vulgar.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's vulgar.
And there's a lot of them. There's like a series.
Of different trees coming out of her.
Truly.
Snatch.
Out of her hoo-ha, yeah.
Her hoo-ha, hoo-ha was my other go-to.
Quite lich.
Quite lich.
That's...
Well, that is troubling, isn't it?
Should we just
the
sit with
one
that for
name
a bit?
Celebrities
yeah,
of the...
Should we sit with that for a moment?
I'm unable to
the
move
celebrities
on.
With only one name from the 80s have got to get it together.
You just so many, my thing to anybody is if you have gotten a lifetime achievement award, mm-hmm. if you have reached that level of fame and influence on the culture,
yeah.
log off.
Yeah.
Log off. Yep. You don't need to be on. Yep. Just log off, log it off.
Absolutely. I mean, there's some celebrities that are on the talk, you know.
The talk?
TikTok. So, I'm so sorry.
TikTok.
I'm
you
so
put
sorry.
An L in there, I thought.
The
that's
talk,
why I
yeah.
Got, yeah.
The talk.
Where I'm just like, you don't have, like, you do not need to be doing yeah. the dances. You don't need to be doing the trends.
No.
I mean, nobody needs to.
But
right?
they do because there's a hole inside them that can never be filled.
Right. Of staying relevant.
Attention.
Yeah.
There's a hole inside them that they will never have done enough to stop it.
Yeah.
The older celebrity that I think is doing social media exactly correct, and I will celebrate her till the day I die,
hold
Courtney
on, hold
Cox.
On. Oh, fuck. Okay. I was going to try to guess, and I would have never gotten Courtney Cox.
No, I was never going to go there.
No, I would have never gotten
Cox's Instagram is so good.
I don't think I've seen it once.
I don't know of it. Yeah.
Because you have to look for it to get there.
Okay.
Such a good point.
Okay.
And which is a good thing, I mm-hmm. think. She doesn't mm. need it. But then when you get there, she's doing a little jokes with her friends. She's having a good time. Mm. She's selling home goods products now called Home Court. And she's doing a little jokes with them, but they're like pretty lame. And I think that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My guy, my celebrity that is doing social media perfectly, Michael Chiklis. Y'all know Michael Chiklis? Michael Chiklis from The Shield?
I can't
I don't
say
know
that
what The Shield is. I don't know who Michael Chiklis is.
About.
Chiklis yeah. heads, sound off in the comments. I know you guys are out there.
Chiklis sounds like a gum.
Sure. You think of Chiklis, which
Chiklis,
is a gum.
Yeah.
Michael Chiklis, he's an incredible actor, and more importantly, he's a father. And what he's doing on Instagram is being a father to his children.
Yeah.
He posted a picture of him with a lasagna that he made, and the caption was, I make a lasagna. That's the kind of stuff he's doing.
Right.
Yeah, Courtney's like playing piano with her daughter. Perfect. Yeah. I think that's really nice.
Perfect.
Yeah.
I gotta say, if you're not looking at Cox's or Chickless's Instagrams, you gotta get on over there.
If you're not looking at
Cox's. Remember,
Courtney spells her name weird. It's CORTENEY.
Well, she's gonna hate to hear that you called it weird.
When she listens to this, she's gonna be. I mean, I don't know how she's gonna take it up.
I think she knows.
Art with cats can be so powerful. Mm. And what I love about the painting you've described.
I'm so glad it wasn't Pizza Cat.
Thank you.
You guys, can you imagine if I came like, and I was like, well, I know exactly what we need to send to space.
Pizza.
Like yesterday.
Laser eye cats. Yeah,
because a lot of those cats are in space. So you could have had some sort of reasoning that was like, oh, like they'll see how they we imagine that.
A lot of those cats, you mean the cats they send into space?
No. I mean the random core cats
they are
exist
in space
most of the time.
Yeah.
God, yeah.
Like, the images are them, like, floating in space on a beach.
Yeah.
Lasers right.
And they are a close cousin to I Can Has Cheeseburger.
Oh, God. I know I opened myself up to this.
I Can Has Cheeseburger? I thought you were going to give us some I Can Has Cheeseburger type shit.
Don't even get me started on Doge. I don't want to, like...
Doge type beat. You're going to give us Doge type beat.
Are you guys investing in Dogecoin?
Yes. Heavily. Are you guys not? I've got like $2 million in Doge right now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That sucks because it's really crashing.
Oh, I'm aware.
Oh.
Oh.
Yeah. My life is super fucked up.
Oh, man.
Have you guys dabbled in crypto?
No.
Me either.
Never.
Not once.
I have no desire.
Okay. We're just checking.
Yeah. And it's not going well for people who have, by the way.
Yeah, that's why I was checking.
Yeah.
That's my new how are you. Hey, did you do crypto?
Yeah.
Did you do
crypto?
I do love to see it crashing and burning.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's hilarious.
I don't know anything about this stuff.
I was still dating men right now.
Crypto
falling would have been so nice. Because men took it so serious.
Are you not dating men anymore?
I'm actively dating a woman and you know her.
I did know that you were dating her, but you're saying there's no chance you date men ever again?
I don't know about ever again, but in the immediate future, I don't see it for myself.
Some people are poly.
You would never date a man ever again?
You never date. You never again date a man?
Okay, both of you relax.
Not a man.
You never date a man again?
Who else to date if not a man?
I don't understand.
I don't understand. You a girl. You date a man.
I'll tell you one thing about me. I don't know what accents are.
No.
So a lot of times I start talking and it gets to a place that shouldn't be super quick.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be in the middle of British. All of a sudden, we're doing Indian.
Oh. Well, you know that happens to me a lot. I go Australian and I accidentally fall Southern.
Yeah, but both of those you're allowed to do.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, but...
But it's not what you intend to.
That's those two. And then I'm sure if I tried, you know, like Irish, I'd end up...
Yeah.
I don't know.
I go for something I'm allowed to do, and I end up something I'm really not allowed to do.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it's not on purpose.
No.
I just don't know accents. I'm not a good accent.
Someone once told me Irish is at the front of your tongue, and Scottish is the back of your tongue.
Back? How do you tap into the back?
Scottish is at the back of your tongue. And Irish is at the front
eating
of your
tongue. Eating the potatoes.
Irish
is killing
at the front
us.
Of your tongue.
Irish is at the front of your tongue.
But Scottish is at the back of your tongue.
So it's phlegmy.
Yeah.
Mm.
They're sick there.
The Scottish are sick.
They're disgusting.
Wait. Bronchitis.
You can't say that. Cut that. You can't say Scottish people have bronchitis. I'm trying to like have a career. This is the kind of stuff that gets us taken
one
out.
One way ticket to cancellation, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I really love your energy today. I have to say, I really, really am such a fan of yours.
Oh, the YouTube video is going to be much tougher than the audio recording.
You're one of my main girls.
Oh.
Yeah. When I think of like girls in comedy, I'm like, you're one of my main girls.
Oh my God. When I think about girls in comedy.
One of. We're supposed to be
like,
best friends.
They're doing so much.
Do you think about girls in comedy a lot?
All the time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Constantly for me.
Yeah. It's constantly on my brain.
Because it's such
a constant drumbeat.
Yeah.
In my
because
brain.
It's like an oxymoron, right?
What are those ladies doing on the stage?
It's like jumbo shrimp.
I feel like I'm in the Twilight Zone.
Because we're talking about women in comedy.
Yeah, because the idea that a woman would be funny is so foreign to me.
M'lady.
M'lady. M'lady, back to the kitchen, methinks.
I'm like, why? I feel like I'm bringing in like a lot of like old meme energy. And I like,
you're pulling it out of
me. I like, don't know why. I'm like, this is what comes out. Like, oh.
Oh my God, what's the most misogynistic opinion you guys have?
Oh, yay, I love this game. Yeah.
Mine's about voting rights, so I'll go last.
That I should not be allowed to work.
Okay. Okay, that's one. And then
I think I'm gonna go credit cards. Like, why do they need them?
Men should have to sign off.
Yes.
Yeah.
You guys do that for women, right? Because I've only ever been able to get one if I.
I've had a lot of women.
And you're never gonna date a man again.
And never again you date a man.
What about the credit card?
Oh, you gonna get the credit card?
What about credit?
Yeah. Only debit, baby.
No, I don't think women should be allowed to vote.
Mm.
Well, because
no, it's well, if I can take that a step further and explain it for you,
yeah.
Sort of like what a man would do.
Oh.
Women shouldn't be allowed to go to school, and so they shouldn't be allowed to be educated, mm-hmm. and yeah. then they shouldn't be allowed to vote. It's sort of it's a domino effect.
Wait, we're kidding, right?
Yes.
Oh,
because
you were starting to make a lot of sense.
EJ, what is next on your records?
Yeah, EJ, what's next on your record?
My records. Okay, this one's huge, you guys. I think they should be everywhere for everyone, including space. Shoe racks. Big ones.
Yes.
I can't say enough about what shoe racks have done for my life.
Yes.
For every space I go into.
Yes.
And it's also awesome because I feel like they really represent, like, I don't know. I feel like they tell a lot about like my culture, which is someone who like owns a lot of shoes.
Shoes, yeah. I've seen you in shoes before.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
Maybe even like a couple different pairs. Yeah. So I just like, I think they're so amazing. Every time I see a shoe rack in like a Goodwill, I'm like, should I get that?
Yes.
Yeah.
Can I tell you about a shoe rack victory that I had?
Yeah.
You're gonna love major this. Win.
You're gonna love
win alert.
Winner! Okay. Wait, what was that? Charlie Sheen.
Winning! Tiger blood. This podcast. I'll tell you this. We don't get paid enough. For me to put up with me, we don't get paid enough.
I shouldn't be getting paid. Woman.
Okay.
Stuff.
And you're so right. Yeah. Basically, when I moved into my new place, there is a space in my closet that's like, it's a little cubby.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like,
perfectly fit a shoe rack.
It's like 25 inches wide.
Mm-hmm.
And I found a shoe rack that is exactly the width. And then if you put two of them, they stack really well.
Oh.
It's exactly the height. So it looks like custom built-ins, but I just bought it off the internet.
That's like the most satisfying thing I've ever heard.
Wow.
Wow.
And it really, my shoes, I used to be just a person who puts my shoes out anywhere.
Yeah.
Oh, my shoes are over here. They're over here.
Yeah.
Now they're on a rack.
They're on a rack. They have a spot. Spots in places are really important to me.
Spots in places.
Like, I need everything to have a place.
Yeah.
I'm not clean.
Oh, okay.
Me either. Okay. I was going to say,
You really volunteered that.
I just want, like, I'm realized
fucking filthy.
I was giving the impression that I'm, like, organized or something. That's hugely incorrect. Yeah. But I like to know that if I were to clean up, everywhere would have a spot.
Can I tell you guys something about these shoes? Because we're on the shoes thing.
Please.
I was hoping you would.
I ordered these online.
Mm-hmm.
That's then okay. I started getting ads for them, and the ad said, simply unfashionable.
Oh, man.
That's someone really started looking at you saying, Shelby.
Yeah, it was like, we know you bought these, and we just want you to know they look bad.
Yeah.
Well, you know,
you're feeling cute lately. Cute. That's cool for you.
And I love them. I can't take them off my feet. And then the ads keep coming in, and they just say, basically, these look like shit.
Mm.
But in a good way.
Aww.
I don't think that they do look like shit.
Thank you.
No, I
finally,
think they look
someone's
awesome.
Saying it.
I think you look like a much older lesbian than you are. But they don't look like shit. They look like an art teacher.
Hallelujah.
I heard there was a secret.
Actually, do you guys want
to
hear something? This is a song I recorded the other day.
I'm so scared.
This is a song I recorded the other day.
Fuck.
I heard there was a secret code.
That was a run.
Yeah, no, that was a run. Yeah.
You're hearing a run.
That was really beautiful.
What do you want the aliens to do with shoe racks, EJ? Because I'm assuming they don't wear shoes.
Why would you assume they don't wear shoes?
They might wear many pairs of shoes. They might have so many
feet. exactly what I was picturing. I was picturing a lot of legs, a lot of feet.
Here's what I'll tell you. If aliens are real, jury's out. Mm-hmm. They're not wearing shoes.
Here's what I'll say about aliens. I think they already exist. They're on Earth and they're octopi.
Hold on.
Okay.
You think... Oh, my God. That was so much. You think aliens definitely exist?
I do think aliens definitely exist. They're that on Earth. I will actually agree to myself with.
Okay. Awesome. So all of Shelby's are in agreement.
Yeah. That I actually will agree to myself with, Your Honor. And you think they're octopus?
Well, I think octopi don't make any sense. Mm-hmm. And they
what
defy
do you mean?
All-
what do you mean they don't make any sense?
They're weird sizes and they can mm-hmm. get into anything.
Really
you can
smart.
Be like, oh, here's a pinhole. Mm-hmm. And then the biggest octopus you've ever seen gets in there.
That's not true.
They're so crazy.
Wait, have you? Caleb, an octopus, have you not seen these videos?
An octopus the size of this room can get through the eye of a needle?
Like, kind
of.
Yeah.
No.
And they yeah. change colors like this.
Yep.
And they just, and like just everything about them, when you look at them, you're like, that's not of this planet. Mm-mm. Nobody else is doing it like them.
Octopi.
Nobody.
I'm going to say
doing
octopuses,
it.
By the way, because okay. it sounds better. Octopuses just cannot do that.
They can. And
they can. Oh, they
and
can
they
see
like predict things.
Jar. They open it like this.
Oh, I'm sorry. Octopus must be aliens. They can open a jar. Is that what we're doing here?
You see sound this? Off in the reviews, not in mm-hmm. the comments. Trying to get those reviews up. Sound off in the reviews. Are octopi aliens?
No, you guys don't have to do that.
You have to, and it's 5 stars only.
If you're going to do it, can you at least give a better reason than the untruth that they can fit through the eye of a needle?
They can.
And then the pretty... a commonplace fact that they can open a jar.
And they can change color like that.
Changing color is fucking crazy. I'll give you that.
And they do it so fast. It's like you can't, you blink and it's different.
Right.
And they blend into anything. Chameleons take forever.
Oh my God. Chameleons take all day.
Chameleons are like change color.
Don't get me started on chameleons.
Oh my God. I'm so glad we're all in agreement about chameleons. They take way too long to change color.
It's honestly, it's sad to watch.
Yeah.
And an octopus, it's like, how did that happen?
They should have the reputation that chameleons have for that.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And why nobody's talking about octopi changing color. Everyone's talking about chameleons changing color. I beg to differ.
Mm-hmm.
What yeah. would be the purpose of them being octopi? Like what they would have, I guess.
They fell in.
Well, I mean, sort of on that note, like are oceans even, like are we considering the ocean the earth really? Because there's weird stuff going there's on so, in there.
I mean, we
as
don't
well.
Even know what's going down there.
Yeah.
I don't like to think about what goes on in the ocean.
Okay,
if
you want
to
leave that be.
If you guys had to do one or the other, mm-hmm. would you rather go to the ocean floor or really far into space?
Oh, I hate both so much. I hate both so much.
I don't like it. Yeah.
I guess maybe the ocean floor.
Oh my God, so different from me.
I don't want to see the size of Earth. I don't want to see the size of Earth.
There's two options. Yeah. That oh, could not be more different.
So different than that.
I actually don't understand how we don't have a higher rate of astronauts coming back and checking out. Because I know that I would not be able to see the size of Earth and then come back and continue living. I'm sorry to say.
They must have like work done mentally before they go to like prepare.
Yeah. There's got to be support groups after they come back, I would hope.
Other astronauts.
Yeah.
Well, like, what are they going to say? Yeah, that was fucking crazy. Well,
you're gonna make, whoa, how do you go on with your day?
Yeah. That's what all support groups are, though, right? You know, all support groups are just like, that sucks.
Yeah, such a good point. Everyone's anyway. Like, man, I'm having a hard time.
I went to the beach last night for sunset.
Oh.
Okay.
This is related, I
sorry.
Swear.
Okay, yeah, I'm with you.
And the tide started coming in.
As it does.
And wiped out the group sitting near us.
Oh my God, took them to
and
sea.
And they had a bunch of sound bath bowls and stuff. So we were like, oh, we got to help, whatever. And then we were like, what are you guys? Kind of like, what's your deal? And they were the person running it was a death doula. And they were all being shepherded to death.
Wow.
And it was... Fuck, so bad to be around.
Oh.
That just ruins the vibe of the beach so hard. Can you do it somewhere else?
It's like, oh no, now we have to know.
Can you do it in Big Bear or something? God, if someone on the beach told me that they were about to die, I'd be like, could you have kept it to yourself?
I mean, some of them maybe were just in grief, but all I know is she was like, I'm a death doula, I help shepherd people into death, and this is one of my support groups. And I was like, are they all dying?
I mean, more
I'm pretty
than likely.
Sure people go to death. I
bet
people go
both.
To death duelas if they also know someone who is dying, right? Fact check.
Probably,
anybody?
But isn't it crazy to think all of them are all of them are really close to death in some capacity?
Yes.
That's not crazy to think about.
It is to see them all in one space and be like, I'm next to a bunch of people going through a lot of death. I don't
think they should be allowed to gather, yeah.
Yeah, especially in public.
It's like, then we were hanging out and we kind of forgot. They had moved a little bit further away because, you know, of the water. And then we just heard them start to sing and I was like, we gotta leave.
Yeah, that would be a hard out for me as well. Yeah.
That would also be my time to exit as well, actually.
Oh, no, we have to leave the beach. Yeah. And then...
So the water came and it...
It took one of them away.
they were closer than they thought.
Yeah, way closer than they thought. But no, there was like a almost like a river type of thing.
Ocean, honey.
No. So there's the ocean.
a river, but bigger. It was crazy.
Yeah, it was like a really big river.
Yeah, the biggest river. The ocean,
I couldn't see the other
like
side.
Like a river that would have taken you to like
the ocean.
Another continent, almost.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
No,
yeah, that's going to go into the ocean.
Shelby, that's
like,
amazing.
The tide came in and made like, kind of like,
You know what I'm yeah. No, I actually know exactly what you're talking about with David.
Yeah.
Sometimes we're right here. Yeah.
So just like that.
Yeah.
Just
for me, by the way.
Yeah.
That whole thing meant nothing to anyone, but Shelby got me. She won me over.
Well, because he knows exactly what I'm talking about.
I do.
When there's sitting water and it's away from the ocean and then it gets added to as the tide comes in and then the tide goes back and they're separate.
Tide pools.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you're talking about?
I guess, probably. I guess I've never really known that that's what they were called, but...
Yeah, no, they're tide pools. They're tide pools.
Cool. So...
Sometimes you gotta let her.
So the tide pool now had been connected to the ocean because of the tide.
Oh, yeah. Beautiful.
So someone was late to the death group.
Oh, no.
And got stuck on the other side. She was screaming for the... And then she left. She left because she couldn't. And I was just like,
no.
Like, knowing what I knew about the group,
right?
That she was there for something sad,
and she
and
can't
was
even
too and was cut off from them entirely from by water.
Symbolic as fuck.
That is.
And when the natural world conspires to keep you from your death group.
Right.
I was like, damn.
What's the takeaway?
What do I learn from this?
It was really something to see.
Yeah. So that was last night you saw that.
So it's fresh for me.
You're bringing it with you today.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess I am.
EJ, what's something so embarrassing in all of humanity that you would delete it from the record entirely?
And before you start, it doesn't have to be the big stuff like death.
The big stuff like war.
It doesn't have to be the big. Oh, good. I wouldn't call this. Actually, I would call this embarrassing because it's embarrassing that people aren't more aware of it. When music is being played way too loud at the club.
Yes.
So loud.
Turn it down.
Turn it down a little bit. I don't think that people. DJs are thinking about the fact that you can cause hearing loss.
Well, because DJs are wearing sound-canceling headphones.
Right.
Yeah.
They are safe.
I am about to be one of the people that wears earplugs to the club, you guys.
Yeah.
I get ads for the ones that let some sound in, but not all of them.
Okay, send me the link, please.
No worries. I'm happy to. It's for concert goers, which it is nice that I get those ads because it makes me seem really cool, but I have not been to a lot of concerts as of late.
You wouldn't call yourself a concert goer?
I would say I like it. But I wouldn't say, you know, there's people who that's like their whole personality.
For sure.
And I am not there.
No.
I found myself next to a big speaker at a club recently. And I was there for a long time. Dancing.
For a moment, thought you meant a big, like a guy who wouldn't stop speaking.
You know, the guy with the megaphone at the club.
You are on one today, Miss Thing. Miss Girly. Oh. No, a large speaker, like the electronic thing at the club.
Boom,
boom. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 boom.
Zaza, boom.
Zaza, boom.
I need to, like, smoke before these or something. You gotta tell me when you're gonna be going.
You know what's absolutely bonkers? I'm so sober.
You're drunk right now.
No.
I've seen you sober. This is drunk Shelby.
This is me on two cold brews.
So anyway, I couldn't hear right for like a day and a half.
Yeah.
Afterwards.
I was
I was an alcoholic.
Yeah.
That's like a problem.
Oh my God. Speaking of alcoholics, I'm so glad you brought that up. When I was a child, I
could not stop drinking.
I was obsessed. There was a running joke in my family because my mother, although we do have some alcoholics in the family, so we're allowed to make this joke. My mother is not one. She can't handle alcohol at all. She has one beer and she gets a little weird. I'm the youngest of a few. And so everyone was older.
I'm the youngest of a number.
I'm the youngest and I won't say how many were born.
There are people in my family and of them, I am younger.
I don't want to be tracked. Anyway, I'm the youngest. The baby, as they call them. And
only child.
I'm the youngest
Huge, huge family.
I'm the youngest of many siblings, mind you. One only child. Has no siblings.
Best friends, all of us. And
all mentoring.
The running joke among the older members of my family was that...
the strange vagueness of it all.
Was that my mom was a raging alcoholic. And they would all go, oh, mom's a raging alcoholic. I'll laugh, ha ha. I was in preschool. So I took that straight to school, yeah. And I told everyone there, my mom is a raging alcoholic, verbatim, raging alcoholic. Anyway, they called my mom in, obviously. She was mortified, but nothing really happened, so that was cool.
I once told someone at school that my mom abused us because she had taken away our PlayStation, and I thought that was abuse. I thought abuse was when you made your kid sad.
Is it not?
And sure, Division of Child Services showed up to the school and interviewed me. And sure, they have pulled my brother out of class as well. And sure, my mom has never laid a hand on us and was furious with me.
I told my friends at school and my teachers that my parents were getting divorced and they weren't. And then I got talked to about it. They were like, yeah, we're so sorry. And I said, oh, nothing's really happened yet. It's just like a feeling I have. And then a year later, they got separated. And I had gotten in trouble with my teacher for lying. And then I, a year later, was like, who's psychic?
Right.
Who knew a little bit?
That's so Shelby.
That's the future I can see.
That's so
She's an
Shelby.
Alcoholic, but she's got powers.
Yeah, I drink to keep them away.
All right.
Wait, Anya, do we have Morse code up?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we want to play something for you.
Yes. It's a sound.
This is a sound from the original Golden Records.
Okay.
Hold on 1 second.
Okay. They played this on the original records. We have to play it all the way through. Because it gets weird.
What'd you think of that?
I appreciated the moment it gave me for reflection.
One of these sounds included on the original records is called Morse code ships.
Now, this sound is a series of beeps known as Morse code, interrupted rudely by the loudest ship I've ever heard.
The sound clip of Morse code on the Golden Record translates to the Latin saying ad astra per aspera, or to the stars through hard work.
Wow.
So what is Morse code?
Morse code is a method used in telecommunication to encode text characters as standardized sequences of two different signal durations called dots and dashes.
Morse code is named after Samuel Morse, who was also one of the inventors of, you guessed it, the telegraph.
Mr. Morse was my art teacher in high school. He's a different man than Samuel, but interesting all the same.
So, Morse code can be memorized and sent in a form perceptible to the human senses.
E.g. waves, sound waves, visible light, such that it can be directly interpreted by persons trained in Morse code. It's usually transmitted by an on-off keying of an information carrying medium, such as electric current, radio waves, visible light, or sound waves.
Now, Morse, not Shelby's teacher,
but Samuel Morse developed the first iteration of the modern International Morse Code in 1837, which brought about a method to transmit natural language using only electrical pulses and the silence between them.
Mr. Morse, my art teacher is a talented painter and has recently retired from teaching to focus on painting full time.
So, International Morse Code encodes the 26 basic Latin letters A through Z on accented Latin letter, the Arabic numerals, and a small set of punctuation and procedural signals.
In the original Morse telegraph system, the receiver's armature made a clicking noise as it moved in and out of position to mark the paper tape. The telegraph operator soon learned that they could translate the clicks they heard audibly into dots and dashes and write these down by hand, thus making the paper tape unnecessary.
I'm just now remembering that in an Applebee's outside of Cleveland several years ago, I hooked up with an older man who was a painter and had the last name Morse. We did stuff in the bathroom, and now I'm wondering.
Mr. Morse was in high school with my father, and my dad once made a sculpture of Mr. Morse's head that was in my home for my entire life before I knew that that too was my teacher. The teacher was in my home all along.
And this is probably the guy that I fucked.
In the Applebee's.
In the Cleveland Applebee's.
And he's a painter now, full time.
So, it was later found that people became more proficient at receiving Morse code when it is taught as a language that is heard instead of on read from the page.
In the 1980s, Morse code began to be used.
Run that back.
In the 1890s, my brain doesn't go past 1900. In the 1890s, Morse code began to be used extensively for early radio communications before it was possible to transmit voice. Can you imagine?
They probably had to use maps to get around back then as well.
This is what I imagine our podcast would sound like in that era.
We wouldn't have been allowed to have a podcast back then.
Because I'm a woman and he is gay.
Radio telegraphy using Morse code was vital during World War II. Especially in carrying messages between warships and naval bases of the belligerents.
Long-range ship-to-ship communication was by radio telegraphy. Using encrypted messages because the voice radio systems on ships then were quite limited in both their range and security. Beep, beep, beep.
Limited security? What is this? The Oscars where Will Smith slapped Chris Rock?
This episode comes out in like 8 months.
What is this? Way back at the Oscars when Will Smith slapped Chris Rock?
Beep, 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 beep,
beep. Beep, 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 beep. That was Will Smith saying, "Keep my wife's name out of your fucking mouth."
You could tell fucking because it had the longer
beep. Beep, beep, beep.
Morse code is so dumb.
It saved a lot of lives.
Is that true? It
has to have, right? Well, I guess it took a lot of lives, but it took the right ones.
When people use Morse code to help save a life and someone doesn't understand Morse code, well, that's a life lost.
Let's move on.
What do you feel like it said, if you had to guess? In Morse code, what do you feel like it said?
Are you friendly?
Oh. Or are you...
Dancer.
Second time in two episodes we've gotten here. Are you friendly or are you,
dancer?
What would you say if you had to pick? Are you more friendly or dancer?
Dancer.
Really? I would have pegged you as someone more friendly.
Have you seen me dance?
No. Exactly. And that's why. We do need to go dancing together sometime.
We definitely. But not too loud.
Zebulon is usually a decent volume.
Okay.
Good. Although, you never know with the vibe. Sometimes those DJs are playing some stupid shit.
Huge agree.
Here's the thing. DJs, play something with lyrics. We want to sing along. We want to sing along. Play something with lyrics that we all know because we'd like to sing along.
Hello.
Play Fantasy by Mariah Carey.
Play is that Fantasy the by hardest Mariah
thing
Carey.
In the world? Why is no one
it
playing?
What's it going to cost you?
Right.
Here's the thing. You're making your job really hard because we would all really like you if you played the songs we like.
If you're a DJ out there and you're thinking of playing a song that doesn't have lyrics.
Mm-hmm. And that we do not know.
And hasn't been in the top 40 in the last 20 years.
Uh-huh.
Change your fucking plan, loser. It needs to have lyrics so we can sing along. And frankly, it should be Fantasy by Mariah Carey.
Yes.
It's not going to hurt anything.
No.
To play Fantasy by Mariah Carey. Put if you and also, by the way, if you want to play Doo-Wop by Lauryn Hill, and then it's got some, put some different beats in it, mess
no
with the
one
beats.
No one is mad about that. Yeah.
But nobody's going
to
be upset.
But if you're about to play Skrillex,
Turn
I would
off.
Go to his concert if I wanted.
EDM?
Concert goer.
EDM.
If I wanted.
If you want.
EDM, how about N-O exclamation point?
Yeah.
I don't want to hear that shit. Put on something with lyrics, my friend, so I can sing along. Because we all want to sing along.
You should try karaoke.
It's not the same because people don't dance enough.
Yeah.
I've done karaoke.
Dance karaoke.
Now that's actually something I would be interested in.
So can you describe the mechanics of that?
It's basically what I've been describing.
Oh.
Which is where it's a dance floor, but they play good music.
Everyone on the dance floor has a microphone.
Shelby's describing a DJ that plays good music.
The lyrics are everywhere.
Everyone gets
the song
lyrics
book.
Are everywhere.
You know how
No, you're not understanding me. The lyrics are everywhere.
Okay. Go with me on a little journey.
Come on.
I'm not sure I can.
Imagine you're at a stadium.
Okay.
You know when the ads go around the place?
Yes.
Like that, but at a club, and it's all lyrics.
So everyone's like circling, trying to follow
lyrics. I love it. I love it, queen.
And we all get to be like, and singing.
Oh, not one song came to mind.
We all get to be like.
It's dead silent.
Yeah.
I have a question. What do you think about the choice by NASA to put Morse code and ships together?
I think it's awesome.
So, just clarifying question. That Morse code was from a ship? What do you mean?
No, so it had Morse code. Beep, 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 beep. Might have been direct quote. And
Jesus Christ.
And then.
God, she's so drunk.
And then you hear the undercurrent of. That's a ship.
That
was spot on. That's exactly what it sounded like.
Honestly, you've listened to that a lot of times. Yeah.
Just now.
Ooh, I'm just another kind of girl. Y'all remember the Zoe 101 theme song?
Yeah.
That shit went bananas. I want to hear that at the club, by the way. I tweeted this recently, but I still mean it.
Yeah.
Somebody play the Zoe 101 theme song at the club. Wouldn't y'all sing along?
Yes. Yeah, I would need it to be playing so that I could remember it, but once I hear it, once it hits these little ears.
These tiny, tiny ears.
Okay, so.
Little tiny ears. Ears for a baby.
My baby. So maybe you are dating the men again.
I keep looking to Anya and Casey for help.
Yeah.
I'm like, Shelby's losing it. Help.
They like this. This is when they like me.
Anya just shook her head no. Anya just shook her head no like 5 times.
All the other times they hate me.
Okay, EJ, we have to ask you. EJ, we're at the end here.
We're at the end.
But we got to ask you, what was left on your list?
Let me double check. I have a scrap of paper in front of me for those listening.
He's literally
doing this better than I did.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm a pro.
He should run the pod,
what the
right?
Fuck?
Whatever.
This should be EJ's
Wait,
pod.
Did you guys just hear Anya or was she... Because she... Still hasn't
EJ,
mic'd herself.
You might not be familiar with this if you're not a fan of the pod. Anya's a huge asshole.
Oh,
she treats us really, really badly, and the listeners eat it up.
One time she made this room 110 degrees and made us record.
She called it a hot box episode. She said, we're going to do a hot box episode. She wouldn't give us water.
That's super smart.
EJ, oh my God, EJ wants this job.
Think about how I am right now. Now imagine me having heat stroke.
Yeah, imagine that episode.
I'm there.
Yeah, go there.
Okay.
And then imagine being me. Because I play the role on the pod. I'm often the voice of reason.
Yeah, you're like sort of dependable.
Yeah, I'm old dependable. You're old trustworthy.
Girl next door, yeah.
Yeah, I'm the girl next door. I got beautiful eyes and tits out of here.
But a kind heart.
Yeah, underneath all those tits is a heart. And it loves. And it loves.
One of the tits is just a little bit bigger, and that's because it's protecting that big ol' heart.
DJ, what did we not get to on your list? I'm begging you to tell us.
Okay, so honestly, on my list, well, I wrote sunglasses on here. That's just because I got a new pair of sunglasses recently, honestly.
Okay.
I think they're pretty cool.
Okay, yeah.
Like, I've been talking about them a lot.
Do you have perfect eyes, sight?
Do I have perfect eyes?
So you said you're changing a lot lately. Wait a minute, as you went to the mall. You're just like, I've been changing a lot lately. Went to the mall. Bought a pair of sunglasses.
Yeah. I changed a lot. I got sunglasses. I got a haircut.
Yeah, so.
People do not recognize me.
Yeah.
Do you wear glasses or contacts?
I don't wear glasses. I do have close to perfect vision. Okay. But this was actually a weird. Sorry, I just noticed both of you are wearing glasses.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry.
No, it's fine. No, it's fine.
No, I just have a complaint about sunglasses that maybe you would have been able to.
You got clip-ons?
No, because
she does have that energy though, right?
Yeah. I mean, my partner has clip-ons. They're very cool.
This podcast.
Shelby has transitions lenses.
No, my real complaint is they don't make contacts for my prescription because it's not big enough for contacts.
Oh, so you have
But it's bad enough that I can't drive without my glasses. But if I start wearing my glasses for a day, it's hard for me to take them off. I can't see as well. Mm. But so then I can't wear sunglasses very often. And that is really frustrating because I love sunglasses. And it's like I have to pay like $300 right. to get them to be my prescription. What's that about?
EJ, can you tell her what that's about?
So...
EJ,
what's
can you
that
please,
about?
Can you please tell her what that's about?
This is
about?
The second of the podcast. What's that about?
Hey, what's that about? Hey, Shelby's insurance. What's that about?
Shelby just posed like the lengthiest, least coherent question I've ever heard in my life.
It was pretty coherent. The problem is I can't wear contacts.
Yeah,
I have to wear glasses. And then you can't wear glasses and sunglasses. That's crazy.
But they're too expensive,
Anya.
They're
really expensive.
We are wearing glasses right now. Were those that expensive?
Sunglasses are an extra like $200 for prescription.
Honestly, I know we were joking about this earlier, but transition lenses might be a good option for you.
Yeah, you might be a prime candidate.
Here. My mom had them and she looked amazing.
Also, don't you have $300?
EJ's been an amazing guest.
I'll give you the glasses. If it'll solve a problem, I'll give you the glasses.
But can I now add on a problem?
Yeah.
Sometimes you want fun glasses. So when you have good sunglasses, when you have good eyesight, you can wear as many fun pairs of sunglasses as you want. When you have bad eyesight, if you get prescription sunglasses, you have to get one shape. You can't go to the store and be like, wait, these look fun, because they won't work for your eye.
So you're wanting like a cat eye situation.
I have really cool sunglasses. I never get to wear them because I won't be able to see.
Shelby, we'll talk about this after.
Everyone is so mad at me right now.
You're surrounded by people who love you.
You're surrounded by people who love you deeply.
I want you to
we're
see in the sun.
Listening
and
are
I
feel bad for me.
Shopping
you have
spree.
No idea
shopping
how expensive
spree.
It is to get
shopping
sunglasses
spree.
At Warby Parker. My glasses are Warby Parker, and the sunglasses are an extra $275.
So insane. EJ, what's the other things we didn't get to on your record?
There's one more thing, and it's the critically acclaimed movie Thelma and Louise.
Oh, love that
I saw
Louise.
It for the first time last year.
Oh, my God. Well, welcome.
Have you seen...
At Taylor Ortega's house.
Oh, my God. Have you seen Gina Davis's documentary on women in film?
No.
So there's this really fun part Gina. Where they talk about, which I think was directed by a man, because I texted a female director friend of mine and was like, have you seen this? Because it's fucking crazy. The stats that Gina Davis and her like Women in Film Institute have come up with are insane. Obviously, we know... Anyway... But it's directed by a man. Crazy. But they talk about Thelma and Louise and like how culture shifting it was at the time. And just like how fucking crazy it was to tell that story.
Oh my God. It's so amazing.
They didn't talk though because it was about women in film. They didn't talk about the most important part of the movie. Sorry to say. Brad Pitt's so
I knew it was coming.
Brad
fucking hot in
Pitt.
It. Yeah.
I rewatched it recently. I saw it for the first time in high school. Didn't take note of Brad Pitt for some reason. I don't know why.
I don't know why they didn't register. sister with me at the time.
I don't know why I was more focused on, I don't know, Gina Davis.
Yeah, Susan Sarandon.
Sort of, yeah. But, yeah, I watched it recently and was like, oh, my goodness, look at his tight little bod.
I had never seen Thelma and Louise till last year.
Congrats.
And I, thank you. And I have never understood, I've always been like, yeah, Brad Pitt's handsome, but I never understood like the lore of Brad. I was like, why is Brad Pitt Brad Pitt? Then I watched that movie and I said, Brad Pitt deserves what he has.
Yes. His little shirtless stick 'em up speech.
Oh,
please.
My.
Holy shit.
Goodness.
So hot. It's crazy.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
I'm happy for him.
I'm so happy for him.
He's from where Caleb's from.
He's from Missouri.
Is he really?
It's true.
What?
I worked. Yep.
They just turn out where's actors there.
I was like, I don't know if I'm gonna. Well, hey, EJ.
Hey.
This was a really great record.
I agree.
And we thank you for being on.
Thank you, guys.
And do you want to tell people where they can find you?
Yes, on the internet at EJ Having Fun on everything. I'm always having so much fun.
At EJ Having Fun space on everything.
On everything.
At EJ Having Fun space on everything.
_ on everything.
Yeah.
Well.
EJ Having Fun on everything is a funny Instagram account.
EJ Having Fun on everything.
It's just you having fun on different stuff.
Well, someone literally came up to me recently and was like, oh my God, your EJ is having so much fun.
No. No, I'm not.
And I was like,
and you were
that's
sobbing.
Close, but I'm glad that's not it, actually.
We gotta get
you
Shelby.
Are, EJ is having so much fun.
We gotta get Shelby hooked up to an IV. We gotta get out of here.
Yeah.
She's so drunk.
I won't let them.
I will remain drunk.
That was a Headgum original.